Good evening, fifth graders. Tonight we're going to be dividing with decimals. It's just like the way we've been dividing. The only thing is, once you get that remainder, we have to be carrying zeros down, so there's no more remainders. Now the answer is going to be in a decimal form. And when you're dealing with money in the future and you're dividing money with decimals, this is why you need to learn how to divide with decimals, okay? Because of the cents involved with the dollar. Let's take a look at some examples here. This very first one, it says a rope measuring 87.6 meters long is cut into six equal pieces. How long is each piece? Okay, so we're gonna have to divide 87.6 divided by six. So I'm gonna go ahead and get some, extend this page, get some extra room here. 87.6 divided by six. Six goes into eight one time. Six times one is six. I'm going to subtract, get a two, bring down the seven. Six goes into 27. Six times five is 30. So we're going to have to go six times four because that equals 24. Go and subtract, I got a three. I'm going to bring down my six. You see how I haven't done anything with the decimal yet? Everything's been the same division. Okay, let's keep watching. 6 goes into 36 six times. 6 times 6 is 36. Subtract, we get 0. So there's no remainder here. There's nothing we need to do extra. Once we get to 0, the problem's done. What we have to remember to do is move this decimal up. Decimal goes right there. So 14.6 is our answer. So how long will each piece be? 14.6 meters. Keep going. We'll get some more examples here today. We're dividing 27.8 divided by 4. 4 goes into 2 0 times. 4 times 0 is 0. Let's subtract, I get 2, bring down the 7. We just did, on the last problem, 4 times 6 gets us to 24. Subtract, get a 3, got to bring down the 8. How many times can 4 go into 38? 4 times 9 is 36. So 4 times 9 is 36. All right. So now we have a 2 here. This is the new part. Watch closely. We're not going to have a remainder today. Okay. So I have to, if we have a number left here, we have to make a zero here. We can make as many zeros as we want. Bring this zero down. How many times can 4 go into 20? Can go in there 5 times. 4 times 5 is 20. I'm going to subtract, I get a zero. That is your answer. Move your decimal up. So your answer is 6.95. I'm going to erase this so I have some space to continue working on this next problem here. Okay, go ahead and rewind if you need some space on that or if you need to watch that again. Here we go. Let's take a look at this problem. 6 goes into 3, 0 times. 6 times 0 is 0. I'm going to subtract. I have a 3. I'm going to bring down the 8. 6 goes into 38, 6 times. 6 times 6 is 36. Let's go ahead and subtract. I'm going to bring down this 5. 6 times 4, we're doing that a lot today. 6 times 4 is 24. I'm going to subtract, I get a 1. I can't have a remainder on this problem. Whenever you have a decimal in the problem, you cannot not have a remainder. So I'm going to go ahead and use a different color so you understand. I'm going to bring a 0 down. 6 goes into 10 one time. 6 times 1 is 6. I'm going to subtract, I get a 4. I can't have a remainder. I have to move this problem. Continue going here. I have a 4. I have to bring down a new 0 because we're not going to have a remainder. How close can 6 get to 40? You can get there 6 times. 6 times 6 is 36. Subtract, I get a 4. I bring down another 0. 6 times 6 equals 36. See what's going to happen? It's going to always continue on. Once you get to this point, you're not going to have to get to this point too often. Once you get to this point, the 6 is going to continue on forever. Go ahead and put a bar above this 6. That means the 6 is going to continue on. You'll notice that with a 3. You'll notice that with a 9. Okay? It's going to continue on. My answer is 6.416 continuous. It's kind of a fun problem. Let's do another problem over here. I'll move this over to the side. Let's do this problem. 8 goes in 8, 1 times 6, 8 times 1 is 8. Subtract, I get a 0. I'm going to bring down this 9. 8 goes in a 9 1 time. 8, I'm going to subtract, get 1. Bring down this 1. 8 goes in 11 1 time. 8 times 1 is 8. Subtract, get a 3. I have to bring down another 0. 8 goes into 30. 8 times 4 is 32, so 8 times 3 is 24. Get a 4. Bring down a 0. How many times can 8 go into 40? 5 times. 8 times 5 is 40. Subtract. Once I get a 0, my problem is done. I'm going to go ahead and move my decimal up. My answer is 11.135. You notice is the problem continues on a little more, but instead of just ending with this remainder like we've used to do in the past, where we just end with the remainder 3, that's not what we're doing now. We're continuing on with zeros. Let's do some problems with some money here. Decimals again. One thing you can also do, and I haven't been doing this in the examples, but you can do this as well. You can just move the decimal up right away because the decimal is always going to be in that place right there. Okay? All right, 3 goes into 6 2 times. 3 times 2 is 6. I'm going to subtract, I get a 0. I'm going to bring down this 2. 3 goes into 2 0 times. 3 times 0 is 0. Subtract, I got a 2. Bring this 1 down. 3 goes into 21 7 times. 3 times 7 is 21. I have a 0, so that means the problem's over. I don't have to bring any zeros down because I have a 0 there. Continue on to the other side here. 9 goes into 8, 0 times. 9 times 0 is 0. I'm going to subtract. I've got an 8. Let's bring down this 2. 9 goes into 82 9 times. 9 times 9 is 81. Subtract, I get a 1. Bring down the 5. 9 goes into 15 1 time. 9 times 1 gives me 6. Bring down a 0 now because I have this. 6 left over. 9 times 6 gives me 54. Subtract to get a 6. Bring down a 0. As you can see, this problem's going to continue on again. 9 times 6 is 54. I subtract to get a 6. So that's why I'm going to put this little bar here because you'll notice no matter what you do, you'll keep on getting 6 after you subtract, so that it's going to can keep on continuing on. Okay? So that problem is over. Now, the last thing I'm going to show you, I know this video is getting a little longer. Last thing I'm going to show you is this. At the very top of all these pages, it says estimate and calculate quotients. Okay? I've been calculating, but I haven't done any of the estimating yet. So I want to show you how we're going to be estimating on this today. Okay? First of all, we have this. We have 87.6. So I'm going to be estimating everything in blue. 87.6 divided by 6 equals what? Okay, we have to make some estimates to make this problem easier. So I'm going to round 87.6. I'm going to round that to the nearest 10. So this makes it 90. 90 divided by 6. Okay, it's a little easier because I know 6 times a number equals 90, and it's actually 6 times 15. So it's 90 divided by 6 equals 15. Is that close to my actual answer? It is. That's a little harder when multiplying by 15, but let's take a look at these other examples we figured out here. Okay. Here's an example. I'm going to use green here. We're going 6, 38.5 divided by 6. I'm on this problem right here. I'm going to round this number right here, 38.5, to a number that 6 can go into. That will help me out. Okay. Because I have a 6 here. So I'm going to round 38.5 to the number 42. If I round that to 42 and I have a 6 here, my answer will be 7. So my estimated answer is 7. It's a little different rounding here than kind of what you've noticed in the past, because we'd either round to the nearest 10, nearest 100, nearest 1,000. But remember, we want to get as close as we can to the actual answer. So we're going to round this to 42 because I know 6 can go into 42. So my estimated answer is 7. My real answer is 6.4. Do you see how that's really close? If I were to round this all the way up to 100 and this to a 10, I would have gotten to the number 100 divided by 10 would give me 10 for an answer, which would have been confusing. Let's take a look at this one right here. We have 89.1 divided by 8. What number can we round this to that is close to an 8 going into it? Okay. My advice is we would round this number right here to 88. Because I know 8 can go into 88. You see how I'm rounding this? I'm trying to find facts that 8 can go into. 8 can go into 88, which means the estimated answer, 8 times 11 is 88. So my estimated answer is 11. My real answer is 11.138. Do you see how that's close? We could have rounded this up to 100 and this to 10, and we could have gotten 10 for an answer. But do you see how 11 is much closer to this answer? Let's take a look at a couple more examples here. Okay, this one, for example, 6.21. We're obviously going to round this number to a 6. The 3, we'll keep that the same. 6 divided by 3 is 2. Here's our actual answer. Take a look at this problem, 8.25. Here's a perfect example that I want you to understand here. This 2 right here, everything I've always taught you, if it's less than 5, you have to round down. But when you're dividing here and you're making these estimations and your calculations here, we want to see what we're dividing 9 into this number. So what number can we get this rounded to so it's the closest to 9? I would round this number to 9. Divided by 9, your estimated answer is 1. Your actual answer is almost 1. Does that make sense, kids? So when you're doing this tomorrow in class and you're estimating, you're rounding, please keep in mind that you're rounding the number. So when you're dividing into it, you can do it mentally. The hardest problem that you've had to do in this exercise tonight is this one right here because you're dividing by 15. I don't expect you to know your facts of 15, but I think most of you could have done that problem as well. Hopefully this helps. Obviously, I'll be walking around and helping you out tomorrow. But remember, when you're dividing with decimals, it's pretty basic. Only thing is, once you get to that remainder part spot, you're always bringing another zero down. Always bring another zero down until you finish with a zero, or it's a continuation, like the six repeated. Okay? I look forward to working with you in class tomorrow.